saw his voice, but I haven't got any report to our some video
record.
Yeah, some video record.
Rogue folks are probably like, oh,
I'm
going to see this show.
No, I
meant
to record
this show. Right, so
oh,
we're probably
going
to start
like,
God.
No, I don't.
Yeah, and our sound man's taking a
peek. I know what I'm going to do with the experience of doing that show. Like, a little more control of stage and all that.
I know I told you yesterday
Oh, that's me.
That's you?
Yeah.
And,
that was some years ago. Huh?
Yeah, yeah.
He was like,
I was wondering if that was
you.
Know,
I thought I was ripping off my face. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
oh, yeah,
when
yeah.
I
just figured because it's my man.
She didn't know that I was recording. I'd come by the business.
It's Tower District Record Time. In the dark backbone of the American light's about ready to ring there. Bye. Actually plugged in the guitar, Brian, so I think this should be working. Is it coming through? Songs from Friends. This is Tom Magill over here.
Hey!
And this first song is his.
And Blake has named it Incident in K-Town.
But I think we're going to change it. I think it should be Theme From.
No.
Theme From Incident in K-Town. I think all the songs need to start. You know how they put the theme, the things in parentheses on the names of songs? Theme From. I thought that was really good.
It's called The Ballad of Ray. We don't know which Ray it is because there's two of them here at least today.
All right, let's get to it.
3, 4. Said the shoes.
intensity here? Is this about the same volume you've been? Okay, all right, that thing again.
Other guys,
but the guitars,
I'll bump it up a little bit.
Okay. You want it to sound like, you know, Foghat at the Selling Arena in 1977.
Woo!
Well, no, not really. All right, so the first song from a friend we're going to do tonight is a song from George Ritalo. Some of you folks might remember the Clowns back in the day. George has been doing music for years and years and years, and is a great guy. And he was actually up here singing this song last night. And the song's called Fool Around. It's from a record he did probably 7 or 8 years ago. You gotta look, find him on CD Baby, I think. Anyways. Yeah?
Yeah, go ahead.
Standing in a phone booth, I'm dropping in dimes. Pick up the phone. I'm so glad you're home. It's a shame that I'm such a nice name. We both got a word when we both wanna play. Call up the boss and take a day off. Well, if you just come on over. Short trip across town. If you would just come on over, well, we could fool around, fool around. I'd show you my boxes full of all my neat stuff. Put on some Latino music, and if that's not enough, I know a way. We could spend the whole day. We'd go to the show. We could go for inside my closet, or we could just talk. You know it's right, because I said it's alright. If you would just come on over, take a short trip across town. If you would just come on over, well, we could fool around, fool around, fool around, fool around. Idea of doing songs from friends. This band down in Burbank called The Armoires, And over the last few years, the armoires have kind of been a focal point, a connecting power. They've kind of got a bunch of, you know, little indie bands together to kind of join their, you know, their very tiny influence to try to make something better. They do a monthly show down in Los Angeles, and also other people have kind of picked up on the idea, and these different groups of this loose collective have been traveling around supporting each other, coming through when they come through Fresno, you know, I'll set something up, or when we go to the Bay or whatever, and they call this collective Big Stir, and it's turned into a bit of a record label as well. And there's even people over in Canterbury, UK that are participating in this little exchange. And there's even a magazine, doggone it, a magazine, just like Jeff Bowman has a magazine now. Over there you can see the Big Stir zine right next to Izzy over there. The lovely lady is motioning towards them if you want to check out what's going on with these bands. Anyways, all this to say, the Armoires are cool, and we're going to do one of their songs. This is called Alessandra 619. You see all right? Or you need more?
Okay, I'm just saying. It seems like there's
you feel like it's dark and dingy.
No, I'm cool. Just asking.
I'm not complaining. I'm just asking. How's that beer? Anybody get a beer?
One, two, three, four. Alessandra 619.
right. You gotta work hard to make us prettier, man. So a lot of, perhaps you know our dear friend Nate Butler. I think
Yay! Everybody
knows Nate Butler. This is one of his songs. It's called Breeze Around the Bay.
Interesting fact, I think it was originally called Man Made These Clouds, but he changed it along the way just because it to be more commercial, I guess. Name was trying to make a buck. So.
He could leave that. It's probably about exactly how much he made.
Yeah, probably. More than one
till like the day before we opened, I think that we kind of finished the last one. And we're gonna end the show with that. But this one's a whole probably 3 weeks old. This one is. It's, you know, old comparison. Anyways, it's called Always Emily, and I called it that because it started because I'd noticed all these songs had the name Emily in them. Simon and Garfunkel had one, To Emily, Wherever I May Find Her. The Zombies had this, A Flower for Emily. Pink Floyd had one, See Emily Play. And I was like, okay, all right. Don't know what this means exactly. Don't know what this song means exactly. But it means something. I hope it means something to you. Anyways, after that whole thing was about a year old, that group, the Armoires, put together a compilation of all these different bands that had participated. And it was like, Big Stir, 1 year anniversary. And I saw that, I heard this song called World Record, and I thought, oh, this is a cool song. And I made Tom teach it to me.
It's three chords, man.
No, there's like five. Okay. There's like five. And they come in at funny times. I feel it. I mean, they come in really funny times.
Let's just start the tempo.
Okay, all right.
I woke up with a headache, a drilling diamond.
Another original song. This one from Mr. Magill right here. A lovely little tune.
And I mentioned last night that when you write songs, you should write them in the register you can sing in, and I failed. And then today my voice is really kind of shot because I was around a lot of nuts. Not people, actual nuts today. A lot of dust in the air. That's okay though. I'm not making excuses. Got a beer, it's good.
3, 4.
Thank you. this song I'm going to dedicate to the bringer of the feast, Bob Lambert, owner of the store here.
Hey.
And we want to thank Bob and
what?
All the people.
There he is. What?
All the people that work here, the whole crew, they've really made a super kind of like a, I always call it a clubhouse, social hall, whatever it is. So many bands come through here, you know, and so we thank the people for opening it up to all of us. Not just a fun, cool record store to look through, but also just a great place to hang out. So, thank you, Bob and crew.
Thank you, Blake.
And, yeah. So anyways, Bob, myself, and some of our record geek friends, and I include myself in that group, definitely heavy record geek, we were talking about this particular album cover with this very, very lovely young lady on it. Very fetching, very attractive. All right, really sexy picture. And
whipped cream and other delights.
That's what I was thinking.
It's right up there with, right? But it's just a headshot, right?
It's just
a headshot. But still, okay. And don't y'all go run off to the bathroom now. But if you want to see it, right? It's as you close the door, she's right there. And one of the record geek friends said, you know, that's Barbara Streisand's stepsister. Oh.
Back in about 30 seconds.
Take your time, Tom. Anyways, the lady is Barbara Streisand's stepsister. And you know, everybody has different tastes, right? Everybody has different tastes. But it turns out Bob really, really doesn't like Barbara Streisand. And it kind of wrecked it for him. So the album kind of came down off the wall soon after that. You know, he put it up there just to be nice to me since we've been doing these shows. Anyway, so I just thought that was funny. And also there's this, you know, anyways, I'm going to teach you just a little sing-along bit from this song, right? And I'll tell you about that too. But anyway, the whole song's kind of based, the whole song was inspired by his wonderful bathroom back there. Yeah, this could go on a while. So let's learn this bit of the song. It says, the words are, hold down that lever. That's all you have to learn right there. Hold down that lever, right? Okay. So I'll sing it, you echo it, right? Right, so. Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever.
Hold down. Oh, am I in the right key? Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever. For at least 3 seconds. For all right, now that you know, let's try it together, right? Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever.
Hold down that lever. For at least 3 seconds. For ultimate success. And yeah, you know, you recognize the lyrics as, you know, coming right off the little yellow sticky note that's right over the toilet back there. But
so you stole those from Bob? Is it? Shouldn't he get it as like a songwriting?
Yeah, he'll get his royalties, I'm sure. So anyways, this song, let's play it for you now. This is for Bob, right?
Go for it.
Life could be pretty as a picture if you enlist her just to fix your life. Sister sing,
Seen any other rogue shows going on here? I mean, there's
hashtag Me Too monologues.
All right.
Tomorrow night at 8.
Right on.
Is it good?
Yes. I'm in it.
Okay, well, then, of course it is.
Who else is here?
Say again?
Songs to Live By, Spectrum Art Gallery, tomorrow night.
All right, Spectrum Art Gallery. That's the one right next to Piemonte's Deli.
Yeah.
Right on. What time? What time's your show?
6:45.
Tomorrow?
Yes.
Okay, then. All right, there's a couple. Jeff, you got more shows coming up?
Called The Last Pioneer. Great band, really good pickers. And we're at 8 o'clock at Fulton Street Art.
One door next to Vinny Medici. Right, right. I guess that's kind of the great, kind of the point of the show we tried to get across. I don't know if we did. Mostly it's been about bubbles.
Yeah,
but the point of this show, and I know it's in Jeff's heart too, is like one of the great things about being a musician or any kind of artist, I think, here in Fresno, is the tight community. You know, people playing for each other, helping each other, whatever field of the arts you're in, you know, whether you're an awesome sound person like Mr. Ray Saddle or, you know, whatever you're doing, it's everybody working together to make cool stuff happen. Yes, ma'am?
Yeah.
Oh, right on. Nice. It's just everybody helping each other out. And on that,
that's cool. You give my son voice lessons.
Super. So on that same thread, this is another song. This is we got just a couple more left. This is a song from a cool group that the husband and wife live in Redwood City, and their group's called the Corner Laughers. It's super charming, super clever songs. And I hope we're going to do justice to it. And this song is, you know, what I want to do is dedicate it to all of you folks who have any young person, any little tiny young person in your life that you love. And because because I think they wrote this song for their little daughter, whose name is Octavia. So this is, the song is called Hey Octavia A. Skeletal bits. And Tom got out the Elmer's glue.
Yeah.
Yeah? Alright, so one more. Have a great road. Thank you so much for being here. And here we go. Stuck in racket, my phone's pinging. Spelotic Indecision.